Welcome to The Snapshot, a series examining the forces shaping and driving global commodities markets today. Ethanol export markets are a constantly moving target, and some recent developments on both the supply and demand sides could cause a major shift in who is sending ethanol where. The three stars in today's story are Korea, Brazil, and the US of A. Specifically, Korean distillation infrastructure, Brazil and sugar prices, and US ethanol exports. Korea imports quite a bit of ethanol. Last year's total was almost 90 million gallons, and that's a fair chunk of money for a worthy seller or three. Some of that ethanol is beverage grade, called grade B, that they turn into a handy solvent with lots of uses. Grade B is more expensive than regular old fuel grade, but it has fewer impurities. Korea has traditionally imported their grade B product mostly from Brazil, but global sugar prices could be throwing a wrench into that smoothly running machine. Global sugar prices have shot up this year as stocks have fallen with production issues. Brazil, which produces their ethanol from sugarcane, is increasingly capturing those sweet, sweet sugar profits and opting for more sugar production. Combined with higher domestic ethanol demand, ethanol prices in the country are up, and Brazil is less competitive in export markets. But what if Korea could make its own grade B ethanol, a straw into gold Rumpelstiltskin situation? That could open the roughly 7 million gallon a month market to a seller with cheaper product. Well, as it turns out, Korea is doing exactly that, adding infrastructure to distill fuel-grade ethanol into a higher quality themselves, giving them access to cheaper feedstocks, such as fuel-grade U.S. ethanol. The U.S. is currently the cheapest source of ethanol in the world, and demand for fuel-grade ethanol is on the rise as more countries, including those in Asia, either strengthen or create ethanol blending mandates. So, a Korean company could bring in a big old ship full of fuel-grade ethanol, refine only what they need to use for industrial applications, and sell the rest to other consumers in the region to maximize their profits. And they don't have to worry about getting caught with more high-quality ethanol than they need. So what are we probably going to see from this interesting little shuffle in global supply and demand? Well, let's consider U.S. ethanol exports over the past few years. With domestic demand plateauing as the U.S.'s ethanol blending volume gets to its peak, producers are chomping at the bit to find foreign demand centers. Expect to see the U.S. take more share of Asian markets now that Korean buyers can refine U.S. ethanol, and Brazilian ethanol stays more expensive with more sugarcane going to sugar production. Until next time on The Snapshot, we'll be keeping an eye on the markets.